for the summer break in school of H.O. Nash Junior High.
Wow.
That's how we ended up getting here. It ain't about the book we just recently got discovered for sale in Wong's now.
Mm.
This happened months prior when school was still open. When students was also still coming to their parents and saying, hey, look here, mommy or daddy, yeah, that's the vibe they're dealing with. They didn't have that yet. So we can't pretend like, you know, we don't know what's going on. Most Bahamians and most citizens, thankfully, they ain't dumb. They ain't dumb. They ain't entertaining none of this no more. You understand? Like you can't, you can fool some people sometimes, but you can't fool all the people all the time.
That's powerful.
You understand?
Yes.
One of the best albums ever, Marcus.
Well, sorry, folks. We just realized that we weren't streaming all the time, but we were on Facebook all the time. So we want to apologize to you who just tuning in into the conversation. And so, thank you, faithful listeners. Say, I don't see all that yet. All right. So we're back up and we're running. Yeah. See, let me go back to this. Right? Hold on.
Talk to me, brother.
Hold on. Marcus, you talk whilst I sort this out.
Everything is said, it has substance. It's interesting how the information is on the table and a lot of us don't want to take it in and apply it and fight those negative forces.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Because there's so much different negative forces that's coming to harm the innocent children. Suffer the innocent children. They know no better. For them to have to be exposed to things that have nothing to do with them. If we look at our childhood life, there's a lot of things we never had to worry about. Because
right.
Being a child, you enjoyed the journey of being a child.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
But now we live in a 21st century where we as grown adults have to fight these forces that the children don't see to protect them from it. Because if we allow those negative forces to come through, then our children is going to be a part of an organization or a part of anything without our control.
But you see, one of the questions I want to go back, because you know some of our listeners would have missed this part of the conversation. We're talking about Save and Protect the Children rally,
right?
That is coming up on Saturday, this Saturday from 6 p.m. and then the rally, the motorcade is at 6 p.m.
Right.
The rally be at 7. What is Lano the Sage would have spoken on how the Minister of Education would then now I would have come back, right, and say that whatever information was erroneous.
Right.
But reading, and I don't want to move from this point yet. Comprehension. Right?
Right.
Now, if anybody who listening to me who did comprehension in school, I need somebody to help me out. It says we have a curriculum circulating on the focusing on literacy, comma, numeracy, comma, helping our young people to articulate,
right,
comma,
right,
to help them have the grounding in the subject matter,
right,
comma, we have a new history text, full stop. Now, if we follow the thread on what she is saying, the subject matter what they were discussing in her statement, she said the issue of a textbook containing the LGBTQ education to be taught in the school has been the topic of discussion of late on television, talk shows, and on social media. Right?
Right.
So if we go back to comprehension, right? They want the children to be able to help our young people to be able to articulate and help them to have a grounding in the subject matter. What subject matter are we talking about? Are we talking about English language? Are we talking about, what are we talking about? Based on her statement, what is the subject matter? And so for all of our English listeners and English teachers out there, please, you all help us. You all help us.
No. Marcus.
Yes.
I'm pretty sure all three of us in this room, we need some clarification, correct?
Right.
Are you pretty sure all three of us in this room, we ain't a talking to one?
Right.
And I'm pretty sure all three of us in this room, when it comes down to the kids, we fed up.
Right.
We fed up. You understand?
Yes.
Simply because this ain't, and I have to speak strongly on what you said. This ain't never happened in our lifetime.
No.
This ain't never happened in our lifetime. We never had to worry about any of this in our lifetime. We never had to be concerned with any of this. However,
right.
The sad part about it is kids in this generation, right to our neighbors next door, they having to combat it. Mm. You understand? Mm. Now, I don't know how much of the news around the world or even next door y'all keep up with, but there was a young man. Mm-hmm. He got suspended from school because he was protesting, and it is his rights. It is his amendment rights that he could protest that, you know, he don't want nothing shoved down his face. He don't want no agenda shoved down his face. And he felt like as if the people in the Alphabet Mafia, they shoving something down his face. And he proved it to be correct because guess what? He got suspended for it. He had it on his shirt. He wasn't into it, and he got suspended. Mm-mm. So guess what he did?
Dying what he had on his shirt.
No. He had his protesting message on his shirt.
What was the message on the shirt?
Oh, the message was saying he ain't got to listen to any of the stuff what they keep on shoving down his throat. That was his message.
No, man, his message, he had on his shirt something about Jesus saves and something
like that. No. No.
Go back and look at the story.
Not him. I know what he's talking about.
This is the boy who was suspended?
It was a couple set of boys who got suspended.
Oh, okay.
This one we're talking about, he had his message saying, look, yo, I don't have to listen to none of this, and I don't have to accept what y'all telling me. Y'all ain't got to shove it down my throat. He ended up going before the members of his constituency and also the board of the members of his school as well. And multiple boys also did the exact same thing. But guess what? This one, he did it so nonchalantly. And I was happy. I was happy of how he did it, you know. You see what I'm saying? He wasn't the only one. There was also another young boy who wrote the message out before he went to his father. And then he went before the subcommittee. So for me, I'm like, hey, the children are now officially involved. They are officially involved. So there's really nothing we could do now. We didn't reach this stage. The kids in Canada, the Christian kids and the Muslim kids by Marcus, but I don't know if you saw this, but this went viral in Canada, even when I was there last June.
Wow.
They started grabbing all of the flags, and there are multiple mafia flags.
Wow.
There's the original one that stands for the first four letters.
Right.
There's the other one that stands for the T people.
Right.
And now there's one where these grown adults are attracted to our kids.
Wow.
These Christian and Muslim kids united and started grabbing all of these flags and stumping them up in the streets.
Wow.
They united Christians and Muslims. Imagine that in this era. Good old Canada, ladies and gentlemen.
Do me a favor.
Mm.
You know, for people who have children, I don't think there's nothing wrong if you are an adult.
Right.
If you are an adult and you have the ability to make your own decisions.
Right.
That is the issue. You see what I'm saying? You have the ability to make your own decisions. But now you're making a decision for young children. You see what I'm saying?
This is powerful.
And they're confusing the children at that, you know. You see what I'm saying? They're confusing the children at that because they're telling the children a particular type of message saying, hey, listen, this is what I'm telling you, but you need to tell everyone. This is what you say and what you believe. And then you could catch these people in the act, you know. Just look at the body language of the children and then look at the body language of the adults when this stuff happening.
Right, right.
And I know you. You of all people, big bro, you very familiar with that. Like that's something what you are trained to do.
Right, right.
You see what I'm saying? So this ain't only getting pushed by the powers that be. This also is getting pushed by our literal family, our literal people next door who, you know, got kids and whatnot. So we respectfully got enemies all around, and I have to call them enemies because when you give a child puberty blockers, listen to that name, puberty blockers. Why are you trying to stop the natural growth of a child, bro?
Yeah, so any of folks, we can jump right back into this conversation. We have the boss man them inside the house. I don't know, this real beam, and I got two bobo. one bobo, one rasta. Which one side of the fence you on? The bobo side or the rasta side? I know you on the bobo side. You're the bobo too. All right, we got two bobo in the house. Now, I know y'all is be on time. We're not having y'all today.
Looking for the place. Yeah. First time coming here.
All right.
So I apologize first of all for our lateness.
All right. And then we got the next boss man inside the house. What's going on?
All's well, my brother.
All right. So we can start with you since you start talking. Yes, introduce yourself so the people get to know who you are.
My name is Salathiel Thompson.
All right.
Yes, sir. And I'm a representative of the sovereign kingship.
Right.
Constitutional government.
All right, your daddy was in the former commissioner of police.
No, sir.
You got the same name.
Yes, sir.
Let's see, daddy cousin.
No, grandfather.
That's your grandfather.
Yes, sir.
All right. And then introduce yourself, my please.
Good evening, family. Good evening. The name is Neil Peterson. I'm also a representative of the sovereign kingship, constitutional government.
All right, and my brother on the side of me.
Yes, blessed day to all your listening viewers. My name is Honorable Priest Ethelbert Harrison, also known as Priest Diamond.
All right. Bless up and glad to have you all here this afternoon.
Yes, sir.
You know, we be talking about the rally on Saturday, so we want to address some of those things quick. But then you all using these titles of kingdom. Where from?
Kingship. Yes, sir.
What is that?
Briefly, we came together. First and foremost, we are common Bahamians.
Okay.
We are men who love our country. We saw the condition of our country and responding to the atmosphere of our country. We see that our country is being sold. We all familiar with the numerous abuses and injuries that has occurred.
Right.
We came with a new type and form and style of government.
Okay.
One of the problems that has assailed this country that we are trying to educate the average Bahamian on is the fact that the very system itself. See, we could have conversations in which we talk about the key bells and many malfactors that we would single them out and talk about the specific actions. But the problem is that they are the symptoms of the system.
Okay.
This system was saddled upon us in 1973. We are aware of all the history.
Okay.
So we don't have to go into that.
Okay.
But what's happening now is this. We've brought forth a new system. We've never had an African-centered system in which the whole process of a government and how to properly serve its people came out of a black mind with Afrocentric information.
Okay.
And so this has been the primary reason why we are suffering the way we have suffered in this country called the Bahamas.
Mm-hmm.
So we would sit down and complain all day if we think that if we change one faith for the other, that all of a sudden the situation is cured. It will not be cured. The system itself must be uprooted.
Mm-hmm.
I always guide people into that 1973 Constitution, Chapter 30, in which the pre-existing laws were saved through a process called the Savings Clause.
Mm-hmm.
And until we uproot that Constitution and we bring forth our own Constitution, and that is what our government is all about. The elected officials are not the government.
Mm-hmm.
The people is the government.
Okay.
And that is the primary message that we bring.
Okay.
You see? And once we know that we are the government, then we have the right and the duty and the responsibility at any time we see the elected officials does not work in our interests to stand up and take this back and then develop a government that would work in the interests of all the people. And that is why we are here.
Okay, so let me ask you a question. So you gentlemen are part of a group that is aspiring to take over this country and lead it in the right way?
Yes, sir.
All right, so let me see if my memory serves me correct. About a week or two ago on Emancipation Day.
Yes.
That was your? On the park in
Fox Hill.
Fox Hill.
That was a segment of us. There was another segment. We was on Steve McKinney's show about
two, three weeks ago.
And then we were on the Guardian Radio.
Okay.
Wednesday and Thursday last week with Aaron Green and Howard Grant.
All right. I hear some little you know, little things in the community.
Yes, sir.
And so, you know, when I see these titles, you know, when I get more so put the honorable Because I was sent a list, and, yes. and the name, the Honorable, was in the front of them.
Yes.
You know, and when I say, hold on now, this does sound like a political thing. You know, I mean, because here at New Vision Media, we don't really get into the politics side That's of it. Fine. But what we try to do is we listen to everybody.
Yes, sir.
We give everybody a platform to have their say and to do their thing. And then now that you're all taking the part or you're picking up this mantle yes. to help protect and save the children.
Yes.
Now I can ask you what I ask. Yes, you Stuart.
Yes.
Of course.
Your involvement in the Protect the Children movement now, is this political or is this about protecting the children?
Mm. Well, first and foremost, we do not ascribe to anything political.
Okay.
And let me give you the brief reason why. The literal definition of politics is the science of government.
Right.
The literal definition of any modern democracy you would see, it tells you that the people is the government.
Mm-hmm.
So in fact, when you're able to define those two concepts, politics is the science of a few ruling over the many. It's as simple as that.
Right, right.
The people, the majority, are the government. We are the government. And so we have a right to take on that name. That's why we have on this name right now.
Mm-hmm.
So when we bring forth, when we speak in this manner, when we share our concepts and issues with the Bahamian people, it is not political at all.
Mm-hmm.
Politics is the only way our people are being taught in how to view persons that aspire to basically come to the nation and produce its philosophies or ideologies to help to move the country forward in a positive trajectory.
Right.
But we see that they have used the concept of politics in a whole different way. So we are not political.
Right.
However, we are part and parcel of the government because the people is the government.
Well, I understand that, Brother Thompson. I understand where you're going.
Yes.
But you know, we live in this society that people start off as activists. They start off as persons who have the best interests of the Bahamas at heart. And then you look, them other two big boys come. Let's call them. They've been calling him the FNM and the PLP.
Indeed.
They say, okay, now I see Mr. Thompson. Mm-hmm. Mr. Thompson making some waves. Mm-hmm. Let me go talk to Mr. Thompson and say, hey, listen, big man, listen. We want you to come on this side of the fence. We can put you in Fox Hill.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they ain't going to put you in Fox Hill, really, you know, because that's their boy area. But anyhow, right? So let's say they put you in the next area. They silence you. You become a part of the agenda. The reason why I'm asking today, is this a, and I don't want the scientific answer. I want the Bahamian one.
Indeed.
Right? In our society, we there is only two or three streams of things that we do. Either it's political or it's activist. In this sense of the matter, I'm asking, is this a political move or is this an activism move?
We are not activists in the sense that activists is operated, meaning that they don't push to actually change the government themselves.
Mm.
We are, again, governmental. And why I don't want you to define me, because then you place me in a particular niche,
mm-hmm.
and if I can't attempt to come out of that niche,
mm-hmm.
then I am colored with this or that. So I wouldn't allow you or anyone else to place me in a niche. Hold on, just let me add this, right? Again, so you could be clever at my stance, and anyone could be clever at my stance here mm-hmm. under the power of my voice, right? Our intention, we have a constitution
mm-hmm.
that does not reflect the 1973 Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
We have a body of law, and we have a system of government that is based upon the information from our ancestors.
Mm-hmm.
So if you call that political, then yes, I would accept that from that perspective.
Mm-hmm.
We're here to raise mm-hmm. our people. We're here to produce a government, not in the fashion that they produce a government, a representative form. We bring in information that deal with a direct form where every Bahamian national is involved in their own governance.
But here's what I'm asking you.
Yes.
Follow me, Mr. Thompson. We can get into that side of it.
Yes, sir.
But I asking you a specific question.
Are we political?
No, that ain't what I'm asking
you. Okay.
Listen. All right, Mr. Thompson.
Yes, sir.
As it relates to Protect the Children rally, right?
Mm-hmm.
Is this a political move or is this to protect the children? Let me take out the word activism.
Okay.
Is it? See, because again, we have a lot of people who are defining some things mm-hmm. to get some political mileage. Okay. Let me finish.
Yes.
Right? And so the reason why I'm asking you this is, right? Because if it is a way to get your name or your recognition out there to attach yourself to protecting the children, okay, then now I need to know how much my foot or your foot, I need to hold to the fire. The reason why I'm saying that, if you are successful in becoming the leaders of this country, right? Or the leaders of the Bahamian people, as you put it. If you are successful, I won't have it on record to say that, okay, Mr. Thompson was here, my good brother here, Diamond, was here, Brother Neil was here. And they say this, mm-hmm. based on when they get this government, yeah. I won't be able to say, nah, I can use this word for you. Mm-hmm. You all come on this show talking shit, right? Saying this is what you all can do.
Right?
The reason why I'm asking you the other part of the question is because our children are under attack. And nobody who is in the leadership of governance in this country, whether it's the PLP or the official government of this country, and the official opposition of this country is not speaking to what is necessary to protect our children.
Agreed.
The part of the conversation that you all walking on, right? We were talking about if you are an adult, you have a right to make whatever decision that you want. You have all the rights, right? But our children need to be children. Agreed. How it is you want to teach my 9-year-old about homosexuality,
Agreed.
Right? But you don't want to give them a Playboy book. Mm-hmm. You don't want to give them a Playboy book with a man and a woman having sex. Mm-hmm. You want to get them a book with two men having sex or two women having sex and a old man showing the penis. That's what you want to teach them, but you ain't want to teach them about heterosexual sex because, that is too vulgar for them. You having these homosexuals come inside the school, dress up, playing like these women, right? You show up inside and then performing these dance, teaching them little boys how to twerk, right? This is what the people who are leading this country is silent on. More so the church, because we can hold the church more accountable. We can get into that. So, back to my original question, right? Is this a political move as it relates to protecting the children, not governance of the country, or is this a way to protect our children?
We are solely to protect our children, because first and foremost, we are fathers, we're children.
All right. See now, me, you on the same page.
Yeah,
we're all based on the same
page. We're on the same page right now, see, because I wanted you to understand where I'm going first. You see what I'm saying? We can go down, that rabbit hole. You see, because a lot of times we have persons who come in disguise, and y'all two brothers should be familiar with this, as sheeps.
Yo, agreed. Listen.
Right?
Agreed.
As come as sheeps, but they are really wolves. You see what I'm saying? When they could sit down and take money from Kamala Harris, and we don't know what the money was for.
Indeed.
Because they ain't telling us the truth.
Indeed.
Right? But wherever she been, she got run from. Mm-hmm. But the Bahamas opened them welcome arms. Jamaica run them.
We call it a piss pot.
You see what I'm saying? So anything that we accept. So let me ask you, Brother Nian, what is your position on protecting the children?
Listen. I grew up in an environment where fathers weren't prevalent.
Mm-hmm.
Most of my friends I grew up with, we had no true guidance, true understanding of anything with life other than what we did. Our parents did their best to provide in terms of shelter, food, and the best in terms of education, trying to. However, the streets prevailed because the family system was already eroded at this particular time in my life.
Mm-hmm.
What I'm saying is this. As parents, it is our sole duty to protect our children. Yes, we represent a particular faction that is to serve the people. Mm-hmm. However, at the end of the day, we are parents first.
Mm-hmm.
And me being a father of three, and I was on the show last time in regards to this as well, plain and simple, I am not giving anybody the right and the privilege to teach my children anything that goes against principles.
Right.
Principles.
Mm-hmm.
Methods are many. Principles are few.
Mm-hmm.
Methods always change,
mm-hmm.
but principles never do.
Right.
And so understanding principles, that is key. That is what gives us a different level of consciousness.
Right.
And when it comes to our children, when you don't give them the opportunity
mm-hmm.
to feel that, to enjoy that,
mm-hmm.
understand that, being a parent to guide them through that, I have a problem.
Facts.
You're trying to teach my children something that goes against morals
mm-hmm.
of my household.
Mm-hmm.
I have an issue with that. If that is what you practice in your home,
all power to you.
All power to you, respect. Mm-hmm. But when you take that
from out of your four walls, mm-hmm. and then decide by your will that it is your duty now to tell my child that that is okay.
Right.
Okay,
then we have a problem.
We have a problem.
All right.
Houston, we have a problem.
And honorable Diamond.
I grew up in a family structure. Father, right. mother, and older siblings. I'm the last out of 16.
Mm.
So I had the proper growth. When it comes to family structure, that is something I could view from a different perspective to say that this agenda what we're facing now is an attack on the family structure on the whole.
Without a doubt.
So, and that is one of the ways they could infiltrate our nation. When we look at the government, what would bring in, and both governments still allowed it, that we could bring in such things as carnival. This ain't just started, you know.
Mm.
So when we could have something like carnival marching along our street and the type of pornography being presented to our children in the front of the streets, nobody say nothing, you know. Mm. We have crowds of people taking their children out there to see these things.
Yeah.
So I start to blame the parents as well with this
right.
situation.
All right.
And pay attention to it, you know. The books that a lot of people find themselves emotional about, these children don't go into the bookstore and purchase these books.
The parents have to purchase
these books. Mm-hmm. So it starts with the parents again. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And then most of these teachers are parents. And then when we listen to the nonsense, someone who I had high respect for, I totally dropped that for Linda Wilson when she could come with the foolishness that she actually brought to the nation and was proud to promulgate it. The nonsense that we need to condition ourselves, our children, to go abroad, to accept certain... It was happening we were going to college from time immemorial. They had colleges to go off.
Right.
And we didn't prepare our children and such. We brought them up with the standards and the morals within the home.
Mm.
And from it was instilled in us in the home, we took it abroad.
Okay.
And understand, not to cut off, but just to add to what Diamond's saying, understand for any nation, for any country, the family, it is the first government.
I want to read something for you because we was talking about this much earlier as well.
Let me just say this right quick.
Go ahead.
I want you to be able to, that you said if you could hold our feet to the fire,
uh-huh.
you could hold our whole head, body, soul, and everything to the fire.
Mm-hmm. Honestly.
Because we hear about our nation.
Right.
We hear about our children. We hear about the people and the children. They paramount.
Mm-hmm.
I just want to make sure we on
bless
the same
up,
level
bless
with
up.
That.
Go ahead, Brother Thompson.
Because you didn't ask me the same question, so I wanted to...
Okay, go ahead. Pardon me, pardon me.
A chance to answer it.
Right.
From my perspective,
mm-hmm.
First I heard when someone told me that Kamala Harris, mm-hmm. the vice president of the U.S., was coming to this country with that folly.
Right.
The first thing I had moved that person to do, and this was a person with a little position, right?
Right, right.
I said, let's take and write a letter of protest.
Mm-hmm.
Let's file it with the courts. We know that the courts are more than likely would reject the letter, but let it go on record,
mm.
right? And then I wanted us in that letter to state that as a nation, as an independent nation, because we're not sovereign, but as an independent nation, we have the right to choose who we allow that to enter into our country.
Right, right.
We have a national interest, though these elected officials never defines it.
Mm-hmm.
But our national interest is coupled with or should be in sync with our value system.
Right.
And so when we face this LGBTQ issue, one of the problems that for most of us, I don't like to deal with this from an emotional perspective. Mm. We missed the mark.
Right.
From time immemorial, that type of conduct was existing.
Mm-hmm.
Right. We know that in this country, we had neighbors, we had brothers, we had sisters, we had mothers, fathers who involved themselves in that.
In our community.
And so there was never a need for any law, because the under their constitution protected the rights of all its citizens.
Facts.
But now we have someone who comes in and attempts to bring a foreign concept into our country that is against our moral systems.
Mm-hmm.
You see? And so for me the question is, why is it necessary in 2023 that the vice president of the United States would seem fit to come into our country
mm-hmm.
to ensure now that we create some type of legal framework for the acceptance of this,
mm-hmm.
right? When this was never an issue in our country.
Right.
So tell me that it must be more than this that they are trying to institute into our country.
Well, could I put it to you, the laws change?
Okay.
Could I put it to you that they went to court,
mm-hmm.
right? And they had a referendum in the Bahamas
okay.
that changed the law.
Mm-hmm.
To say that same-sex marriage, boogery is off the books.
Mm-hmm.
Being caught having sex with people in public is now off the table. Can I put that to you? Yes. Did you hear that was published? Did you take part in the referendum?
I heard it rumored.
Well, I just came home back in 2018.
Under which party was this done?
I'm glad you asked me that, Honorable mm-hmm. Diamond. Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you why I'm glad.
Yes.
Because you ain't over there, right?
No.
You know what it need? You know what the Honorable
Not done? At all. And this is what happens continuously under this type of system. Okay. That they make decisions on our behalf and they'll come into the people mm-hmm. with these issues. And then the world will look at us and say, oh, the Bahamian people accepted mm-hmm. this. Indeed. The Bahamian
people,
totally different.
This is what I did. Mm-hmm. I take it an emotional state now.
Okay.
Yeah. It never happened. It never happened.
So what you said happened?
That never happened.
Okay.
So on our book, the law is stating that those things are against the laws of this country. Okay. Let's take out all the garbage when we talk about we're a Christian nation. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about the laws that govern this country.
Now you're on to it.
You feel me?
Indeed.
Now watch this. Mm-hmm. The reason why I asked you that question is, where are the parents in all of this? Mm-hmm. We have lawyers upon lawyers in this country. Mm-hmm. Why we haven't taken a class action suit against this government? No, I don't have no PLP government. I don't, because I don't run on with no PLP government or FNM government. If you govern in the Bahamas, you're the government of the Bahamas, right? Yep. So what I'm saying is, what happened to all the parents who say, okay, you're all trying to put this stuff on my children. Mm-hmm. Why we haven't taken out a class action suit against the government? Mm-hmm. Why haven't our people decided that, okay, listen, 20 or 30 of us can get one Queen's Council. We can run for King's Councils now, right? We can run for them for all kind of little foolish things. We get your property, you know, you need somebody owe you some money, so you want to take it to from one court, you're going to take it from magistrate court, you want to take it to Supreme Court, then you want to take it to the appeals court, then you want to take it to the Privy Council. Mm-hmm. Where are people, why we are not fighting fire mm-hmm. with fire? Mm-hmm. When Kamala Harris was here, there was a fellow pretending to be a woman mm-hmm. at the airport. She said to him, we are here for you. Mm-hmm. The person who they was talking about, I commented, so why they didn't take you when they was leaving? She came here on a private jet, Air Force, whatever, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6, whatever. She come on, right? Mm-hmm. Why our people so silent, right? We had Priest Rado on the show a couple of weeks ago, right? I asked him, where the Bobo them? Mm-hmm. I was so happy, bring up the flyers here. I was so happy to see Priest Rado was on the flyer. I am so happy to see you all here in the studio.
That's me and the flyer.
I didn't see you long time, big man. Okay. I only asked him the question because that's my job to ask the question.
Indeed.
Right? I am so happy to see that a segment of our community that was being ostracized for years mm-hmm. has now picked up the mantle Indeed. And say, listen, foot in ass. Mm-hmm. Feel me? We had enough. We being silent too long. They only look at us as fellas, them selling peanuts. Mm-hmm. So they treat us as such.
Indeed.
I am happy to know for the past couple of months, I've been talking to some of y'all, but I don't hardly talk to the Rasta man. The Rasta man don't really like talk to me. Because I'm going to ask questions because I want to know.
Yeah,
you see what I'm saying? If you come to me and you say, well, Hubert, listen, so and so and so, I want to ask you how. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? I want you to lead me down the rabbit hole till I say, okay, I gee.
Yeah. Indeed.
You see
I get you.
Why have the Bahamian population mm-hmm. gee on this matter?
May I?
Oh, sorry.
Go ahead.
No.
I wouldn't say the Bahamian population is gee in this sense on this matter, mm-hmm. as opposed to.
Hold on. For all our listeners who don't understand what gee means, that means I give up.
Give up, yeah.
All right.
Give way, yeah. Mm. What I say is this. The Bahamian population has been conditioned, mm-hmm. and we've been conditioned to respond to people that we feel or we've been taught to accept as authority figures, mm. pastors, policemen and policewomen, mm-hmm. so-called elected officials who we continuously say are the government bitch and not the government, mm. right? And so what we do is this. We've allowed them to form the narrative. Mm. And to a great degree, the blame of the Bahamian people, from my perspective, is that we've become lazy. We've allowed the so-called rulers in this country to form a narrative and keep us out of the conversation.
Mm-hmm.
See, we don't call for, in the constituencies, when there are conversations to be had before any bill is passed or any situation. Like, take, for instance, right now, the countless murders of our young sons.
Mm-hmm.
And this really is a crisis. Mm-hmm. But no one is talking about it. No one seems to care about it, right? And so if the Bahamian people them hasn't gotten together right now and demanded to have their voice heard, mm-hmm. because we don't understand the concept that we're the government. And so what I'm asking the Bahamian people to begin to do right now is stop depending on other people creating the narrative.
Mm.
As long as they don't hear it on the radio,
mm-hmm.
as long as they don't hear someone else say it,
mm-hmm.
as long as they don't hear the pastor speaks about it in church,
mm-hmm.
or one of the elected officials talk about it on TV,
it's irrelevant. Exist.
Exactly.
Mm.
It'll be happening in this country all day, every day.
Right.
You see, and again, I use the case in point, the many murders.
Mm-hmm.
We come, the police will come on, count the statistics every day. We check our phone to see mm-hmm. a new face.
See if somebody gets shot last night.
Mm-hmm. But not a single elected official. Because right. as long as the elected officials don't give the word to marshal the Bahamian people now,
mm-hmm.
and then we stay in our hole until it hits home.
Right.
And so there is a level of any term I can come up with is mental laziness
mm-hmm.
that the Bahamian people is engaging in allowing others to define the narrative,
right.
and then allowing them to come on
right.
and more or less put whatever a fury or fire they have behind that narrative,
mm-hmm.
instead of realizing that part and parcel of the indoctrination process that we most people have come in contact with tells me that the Bahamian people is passive. I don't accept it. I am a proud Bahamian, and I know that I am.
Right.
You see, so I don't accept that. But this is part of the reasoning that foreigners like to say that Bahamian people is passive, you mm-hmm. see? And I believe that until Bahamians, not the elected officials, until Bahamians begin to actually stand up, create their narrative of what's actually happening over here, and then defend that narrative, then we'll begin to see serious changes in this country.
All right. I want to say something to what you say.
Yes.
But let me go to Neil first and then I can come to you. Then I can I want to say something. I want to ask you a particular question.
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Well, really, the whole idea is that our people, and just piggybacking on what Salathiel said, our people have become lazy mentally, and that is not because of their will. It was actually saddled upon them. For example, if you check the media, whatever the media says, people tend to say, oh, let me check that out.
Mm.
Let me look into that mm-hmm. from that perspective.
Right.
When it comes to these particular instances, they have softened us up. They said, first of all, how do you invade a bee's hive? You know, if you pull up on a beehive,
smoke them out.
Say it again.
Smoke them out.
And what does the smoke do?
Confuse them. Disorientate them.
Indeed. Uh-huh. So that is the state we're in now.
Right,
we are in a disoriented state.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the key is, how do we get out of that?
Mm-hmm.
See, the elected officials today, they ain't gonna give us that type of outing because it is what drives them. It gives them power. Because we have taken a back seat to what we need to be doing and put it in their laps.
Right.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
That has to change. The only way that's going to change within our country is through a system that is designed to create leaders.
Okay. Go ahead, Honorable.
But along with what my colleagues have said, we could see the issue of complacency mm-hmm. in the Bahamian people also. Then a lot of fear of being victimized. Oh, I got my job. Yep. I don't want to be fired from here. I don't want to be seen as such.
Right.
At the same time, we sugarcoat a lot of issues that are serious within our country that we think marching solves everything.
Mm.
It's good, you know, that we could get out there and show that we all about it. But we need to get to the core root of the problem. Mm. And like how you just suggested earlier, why not lawsuits are not being issued in these regards of the problems we face today. And this is the reason now for the system has to be changed. This
right.
type of government that we are bringing forward, or governance for the people, it has to be implemented.
Okay.
This is where now every individual Bahamian is called on to be a part of it. And you take out the middleman. You take out that representative that you have elected
mm-hmm.
to do your will and bidding. And was always failing for the past 50 years, no matter which one they get.
Mm-hmm.
And like Honorable Salathiel said, if you even move certain characters, the system's still there. So we have to uproot that system, destroy it, get rid of it, and implement what is conducive for us as people, as Bahamian citizens.
You know, what I can say to the tree, y'all? And I don't normally say this to people.
Oh, Lord.
but they're all speaking with one voice. Three different men speaking with one voice.
All praise be to the Most High.
I'm going to tell you why that's so important to me. I don't know about other people. That obviously means that you all find the common ground.
Give me, I want you to adapt me.
You all find the common ground to understand that, listen, we have a problem.
Yes.
Now, let me put another question to you all. And let me tell you why whatever what the three of y'all say was the same thing to me. Our people now. I talk about our people now. You know who I mean by our people, right?
Bahamian people.
No, our people.
Our
black people.
Yes.
Melanated people.
Well, when I'm speaking with the majority. Okay. The majority is melanated.
No, see, because sometimes I have to go the global too, because we got some global people listening. So our melanated people, but now we can. Especially, I can bring this home to the Bahamas.
Yes,
because this is the only place most of us only know.
Indeed,
you know, I had an opportunity to live in foreign, and when I got tired living, I say going home.
Indeed. Say it again.
Home. I going home. Because I don't need to put up with this thing in your country. Indeed. I don't need no papers to work there.
Indeed,
you see what I'm saying? Yeah. I bore with my papers.
Indeed.
Here's why our people the way they are. 400 years of slavery.
Keep going.
That's the physical slavery. Mm-hmm. 100 years of mental slavery. Right? 100 years economical slavery.
Keep going.
Now we in a new era or dispensation of another 100 years. Mm-hmm. Right? Of media slavery. How many children that you know have a cell phone right now?
All.
When I was growing up, my kids, I never bought them a cell phone. They bought their own cell phone. Mm-hmm. The only thing they had access to was a laptop or a computer, and it was mine. They ain't had no Google. They ain't had no nothing, you know, because then I understand the device. Mm-hmm. When you open up your children to certain things, this is what you're going to get. This is why our people have become, people call it lazy or passive. No. If you ever understood the system of the Willie Lynn system, give them their own person, their own melanated person, the person who looked like them, and let them rule over them. Back in the real slavery days, they used to call them the host nigger. Right? When master say we sick, the host nigger say we sick. When the farm burned down, our farm burned down. And this is the type of governance we still have in this country.
Yes.
Because our master, whether we want to accept it or not, we still serve in a master because we're not independent, my brothers. We have self-governance. Because the reason why we have self-governance is because if we were independent, we would have said, I swear my allegiance to the Commonwealth of the Bahamas and the people that we serve. We say, I serve, when they take their oath to go into the House of Assembly.
Preach, brother, preach.
Guess what they just say? I take my oath to the king, his heirs, and his successors.
In perpetuity.
You, give me some daps, Rastaman. So you understand what I'm saying. Truly. So we still in the system of not governing our country the way that it's supposed to be governed. We are taking instructions. And this is why it is so easy for the people to come in and say, hey, see this $100,000? I want you to push this homosexual agenda on your people. Because we know those Caucasians. Y'all know what I'm talking about, right? Those Caucasians, they used to practice this thing back from in our time when we was ruling the planet.
Indeed.
They were practicing this homosexuality. Mm-hmm. If you go back and look at the Greeks and the Romans and all of them, most of the kings and the pharaohs and things, they were homosexuals.
The reasons for the fall of the empire.
You understand what I'm saying? Dr. Miles Monroe said in one of his speeches before he died, when you take on that spirit, that's the only thing can leave for you to do is fall. When you accept this homosexual, let's look at the great United States. What's happening to them right now?
Decline.
On the downward
corruption, self-destruction. Only goes downhill.
You see what I'm saying?
That's the last stage of a nation's fall. Okay. Last vicious.
We got all excited about Barack Obama. Mm-hmm. Barack Obama introduced homosexuality straight across the board, worldwide, because people say, oh, we see our own. Mm-hmm. Okay? Mm-hmm. He was the true resemblance of what they call an Afro-American. His mother was what?
White.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
which was an European, mm-hmm. and his daddy was an African. So when you put them together, you get that same Afro-American. Let's bring this home to the Bahamas.
If I may just interject with what your narrative mm-hmm. as we go along, and mostly for our listeners out there, we were never slaves.
Mm.
We were never slaves, and we want our people across the globe to know that. When they brought our ancestors over here mm-hmm. on ships, they were stolen away from their land by common criminals.
Mm-hmm.
So let's get those views to their point. We came here and landed here with our sovereignty intact.
Right.
There was no negotiation or agreement between our ancestors, our forefathers, with these common criminals mm-hmm. that we ever passed over that sovereignty. When the Honorable Salathiel started to speak, he was showing you about our 1973 Constitution.
Mm-hmm.
That there, again, is what you just explained,
mm-hmm.
that we're not independent. I mean, mm-hmm. we're not sovereign. And we hear a lot of persons talk about us being a sovereign country. We're not a sovereign country. We're sovereign people
mm-hmm.
in an independent country. So we're being held hostage by that narrative mm-hmm. and conditioning ourselves or continue to call ourselves slaves. And the criminals, we call them master. But we can't continue with that.
But my honorable brother, would you agree that some of our people were enslaved? Some was indentured people, and then some of us...
No, I don't agree that they were enslaved.
Hold on, my brother. And then some of us are indigenous people to this place, right? The reason, okay, let me, if I take where you go in, right? If I take the word slavery off the table, right? Mm-hmm. The only narrative that you could come up with now is that we were in prison. Our people.
I tend to tell you no.
Our people or our forefathers that was brought to this country. Let me use another word then. Our forefathers and mothers were kidnapped.
Precisely. I could ask. That's
good enough, you?
Thank you very much.
Okay.
May I add to it briefly?
Yes. Go ahead.
The reason why this is so important, right? Mm. This has a lot to do with, remember, now, narrative is everything.
Mm-hmm.
If I create the narrative 9 times out of 10, if you accept my narrative, each definition I put in the development of that narrative has a boundary to it, a limit to it. Slavery and everything involved in it, even the term slave, was an economic agreement. What you talk about indentured servitude,
mm-hmm.
they were economic policies created by Britain. Now the problem is this. If someone is charged with taking a woman and raping a woman, mm-hmm. that's a criminal act.
Right.
But suppose now the perpetrator, having done this, decides now to define that act.
Mm-hmm.
You see?
What is rape?
I wouldn't even go that far, but which is correct.
Mm-hmm.
But he say, no man, she willingly gave herself to me,
mm-hmm.
you see? And then suppose now, after he created that, the so-called judicial officials take his version of it.
Mm-hmm.
But all the evidence is there upon this woman, right? From the burst lips to the black eye, to scratches, to show that this was by force.
Mm-hmm.
This is what was done to us as a people.
Right.
Our historians them said that over 200 million of us was killed in the process. So you have mass rape, mass hostage taking, mass murder, mm-hmm. right? And again, like my brethren here, Priest Diamond, Honorable Priest Diamond just said, right? When they brought us to these places, we enter into no agreement with them.
Mm-hmm.
And so to make to add insult to injury, they gave us the definition to lessen our act. Look at the pale people that call themselves Jews, right?
Mm-hmm.
They tells you, they define their Holocaust, mm-hmm. right? And you know it's murder because they say it's a Holocaust.
Mm-hmm.
We don't even use the African term, amagamizi,
mm-hmm.
right? To even express what we say. We keep saying slavery. So slavery doesn't even carry the connotation of the murder that our people need to understand.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we say don't use it. If our people them know that they were taken from the land, what we began to do now, be instilled in our sons and daughters, a lion heart.
Mm-hmm.
You see? But as long as we tell them that we were slaves and we came over here by slave, these were common criminals, idiots, stupid.
Mm-hmm.
The pale man, I have never met a pale man yet with the mind I have.
Well, you see, my brother, see, this is why the conversation is needed to be had. Mm-hmm. You see what I'm saying? Some of our people will never understand a word what you just say.
Indeed.
Because they refuse to even accept that. You understand what I'm saying?
We have
some people walking around here calling themselves conscious men and women. But they still unconscious.
Indeed.
Because if you understand what conscious really means,
yes.
Right? That means I must be able to meet with you, Brother Salathiel.
Yes.
Brother Diamond, I mean Brother Diamond and Brother Nian.
Yes.
We have one common goal.
One.
You see what I'm saying? I don't care if you is a Buddhist, if you're a Rasta man, if you're an Englishman, if you're a Chinaman. I don't care. We have a common interest.
Indeed.
That's what we call conscious.
Yes.
And then you apply the thing that you know how to get it done.
Hey.
And this is why I say I gotta give you all three props. Because then y'all done peeped the game.
Yes.
Again, this is the reason now for this system having to be uprooted and our people become educated.
Here's what I can do for you.
With our information.
I got all ears.
Here's what I can do for you. Because my good brother right here, this is Sage, Lano the Sage. He's called himself the conscious artist. Okay. Right? And that's my partner, right?
That's good stuff.
I gotta have you all back here. Let me tell you why I have to have you all back here. Because, and see, sometimes people need to hear the other side of the story.
Yes.
You feel me?
Only if the lion can tell his tale.
You see what I'm saying? And the reason why on this show, this show called On the Streets. Is we street niggas.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? We street niggas.
All the time.
Right? We might be able to articulate some things and speak the king's English. But we know how to talk to the common man.
Indeed.
You understand what I'm saying? And so I can't do a disservice to you, honorable men. I can't do that to y'all. I can't do that to y'all. Y'all was invited here to talk with the Protect the Children rally. We don't talk about that. Right? We don't talk about that.
And I think even what we're dealing with right now,
it's going to show us how to protect the children.
Precisely.
And we can talk off air.
Indeed.
But what I want to say to y'all and me, I am what people consider to be a seal. I don't see Brother Neil over there with the ankle on his neck.
Yeah, man.
I don't see the bobo on the side of me then wrap tight and you leading them.
All praise to the
see, I don't see this. I don't peep the game.
All
but
for
in
all for our people.
In the essence of what we need to do for our people, I can tell you all my brothers. I can open up a platform for you all.
Okay.
Like how I open up the platform for all.
Indeed.
Whenever you won't come back here and let's reason, we can reason.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
Because again, people need to start hearing the other side of the story.
Please.
See, because I understand your passion. Mm-hmm. See, when you spoke, when you talk about the lion heart.
Yes.
You see my heart?
Yes.
Look at my heart. When you talk about the lion heart, right?
You mean like that? Okay. All right. Sorry about that. I apologize.
When you see, when you speak about the lion heart, people don't understand what the lion heart means. People ain't gonna understand what self-governance means.
Mm.
People ain't gonna understand that we need to come together collectively to fix these things. Some people ain't gonna understand that we still segregated in our own thoughts.
Indeed.
Big time.
You see what I'm saying?
And you get me fired up, man.
All right. They ain't gonna understand that I could go to my brother and touch him on his shoulder without disrespecting him.
Indeed.
Because then he's a bubble man and you know he get his little thing. Mm-hmm. I say, I don't know what that means, so let me back off from him. And I come to you and you're here, I'll twist up and I'd be like, mm-hmm. But I go to him and I see him and I start doing him, so I look at each other and I say, oh shit, this nigga went wrong. Let me go this way. Because he ain't wear no cross.
Yeah.
He don't know Jesus.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Indeed.
But in the commonality of time and the commonality of what we're supposed to be doing.
Mm-hmm.
Is what you all project. Is what you all bring in.
Exactly, brother.
You see what I'm saying?
Exactly, brother.
And for two Rasta man, right? The show be one ball head. That's powerful. I can use Roddy Morgan way. This is powerful.
This is very powerful.
This is powerful.
This is
so
powerful.
What this is saying to me, meeting you all for the first time, you are practicing inclusion.
Indeed.
My brother,
you're only practicing separation.
No.
Let me ask you this question.
Man, you get me fired up, man.
I can start with you because I like your fire, you know? It's a fireman, you know? you're like one of my idols. Capleton, you know? You going to burn down the place. This one can articulate it because then he can say, hold on now. Let me explain what this means. And then that one over there, he can kick it hip, right? Let me ask you this question.
Yes, sir.
Based on what is happening in our country, and we always talk about this murder stuff that's going on in this country, we losing our men.
Mm-hmm.
Could I put it to you that this was planned First, I can give you three things, right? One was to remove the men out of the home. And we can go back to the same thing when we was kidnapped.
Yes.
I ain't going to use slavery because yes. you.
Including the attack on the family structure.
Hold on, hold on, hold on. And I tell you, don't jump the gun. Man, don't jump the gun.
Pardon me again.
When we were kidnapped, right, in order to get it, the family.
Indeed.
They had to do some things.
Yes.
We all aware of buck breaking.
Yes.
Keep it real.
That was the introduction of homosexuality in our culture. They rape our men. In the front of our women and yes. children.
Mm-hmm.
So the women now get this level of independence, mm-hmm. you know, or disrespect for the men.
Indeed.
So then our women pick up this, our melanated women are the only women who walk around and call themselves independent. Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. So they infiltrate the other woman, mm-hmm. the woman raising the children.
Mm-hmm.
Now here comes 2023.
Mm-hmm.
They start calling women. What they call them sage? Biting people?
Yeah.
And what they call the vagina?
The bonus hole.
The bonus hole.
Say what?
So, yeah, the same women who walk around this place talking about, oh, they got one gay friend.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, he nice, man. He's a cool dude. You know, he understand what we going through. Mm-hmm. The same dude now calling you. What do you call him? Oh. The bonus hole.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So now you say, okay, now we get the women out of the way.
Mm-hmm.
Women can't identify themselves as women no more to these people.
Indeed.
So now they want to go to the children.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So you get the children.
Mm-hmm.
The children can't have no more children.
Mm-hmm.
So you end that civilization. Oh, right?
Total genocide.
So the main aim is to kill. The kid, not their own, you know.
No, us.
Not their own.
No. Melanated people
to say, see, because Planned Parenthood didn't work.
No.
The pandemic didn't work.
Indeed.
All right, so we had to go back to a strategic thing and say, okay, you know what?
Mm-hmm.
Let's go back to the first thing that we get is niggas,
mm-hmm.
homosexuality.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
So they destroyed the whole family, Honorable Priest. They destroyed the whole family.
Mm-hmm.
Down the line.
But what they didn't envision is, mm-hmm. and this is what I can put on you.
Okay.
They didn't expect some lion hearts to show up.
So let me show you something, right? If I may, and I hope I don't offend your listeners, right?
Man, talk, man. Just don't cuss.
I am a product of... No, definitely. No.
Uh-huh.
I am a product of 28-year imprisonment.
Right.
I recently came out of prison.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone who know my name in the 80s,
right.
know me. When mm-hmm. I tell you that, know me.
Mm-hmm.
My name meant something in this country.
Right.
I went on the run for the most serious crimes in this country in 1989,
mm-hmm.
right? And I went to America. And they held me along with the Bahamian police, the Interpol, and the American FBI for 7 bank robberies. I was convicted of 2.
Mm-hmm.
I spent 28 years in prison. My first year, before I was even, I just want to give you an idea of my mentality.
Mm-hmm.
Before I was even went to trial on my initial charges, I picked up charges in prison because I had the right to escape. I didn't ask to be in prison.
Right.
You see, so I was charged with murder, attempted murder, possession of a firearm, shooting an officer, taking hostage of an officer. So my first 16 years was locked down in the highest level control unit. I don't know if you're familiar with Marion and ADX.
Yeah.
I spent my first 16 years there.
Mm-hmm.
And there, the information that I brought home, I met the God of our ancestors
mm-hmm.
and was given specific information to come back here.
Mm-hmm.
From 1991, 2007 became the first time I was placed into what would be called general population. So the only persons I had access with for the first 16 years were the persons who was bringing my food. I was locked down behind 2 doors.
Mm-hmm.
I had a slab of concrete in my cell and a shower in my cell
mm-hmm.
and a television.
Mm-hmm.
You see? When I came out of that condition in 2014, for the first time, they reduced my custody and security level from high maximum to a medium.
Mm-hmm.
And they sent me for the first time to a medium. There at that medium, a professor heard me speak. And he built a program around me where I made history in the United States,
mm-hmm.
federal or state.
Mm-hmm.
I held the title of an adjunct professor. I taught criminal justice, Aboriginal African studies, and constitutional law.
Mm-hmm.
They were busing in top 20 students from a top 20 university, senior students from Pitt Bradford into the prison where I taught these things.
Mm-hmm.
I was offered to stay there. In the academic world, if anyone know about it, the highest achievement you could achieve is the ability to publish papers.
Right.
I co-authored with a tenured professor.
Mm-hmm.
These things I could prove to you. I have all the information.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
You see, you could talk to the professor and everything, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I just telling you how from a nothing and a nobody, the heights the Most High brought me to when I was at my lowest, right?
Right.
But and I haven't even began to even tell you the prophecy that was given on my life while my mother carried in my womb. I grew up as an Israelite. I didn't grow up under Christianity or anything like that.
First.
And when I say Israelite, I'm not talking about the set on the streets
I
that practice religion. Mm-hmm. I am a hardcore nationalist.
Mm-hmm.
You see? And so I was given a certain level of information to come home with. When I asked the ancestors who gave me the information, they told me to return back home. Since my return back home in 2018, January 9th,
mm-hmm.
they reincarcerated me in Foxville, charged me with the same, they charged me 8 charges, put stipulations on me, signing in 5 days a week, couldn't go to the airport, different things. In 2020, I renovated the charges, so I have no charges over here.
Mm-hmm.
You see, so when I tell you, I lived a particular life. I don't just talk it.
Fox.
Believe me when I tell you that. Mm. You see,
mm-hmm.
I came here with one goal in mind,
mm.
under the direction of the ancestors to liberate my people.
Mm-hmm.
You see, that's the only goal I have. The so-called elected officials does not serve the interests of so-called Bahamian people, point right. blank period. There need to be no discussion in this.
Mm-hmm.
You see, the system that we have, no Bahamian was involved in sitting down. In fact, when we started this, one of the things we do is we sought out the founding fathers.
Right.
We spoke with Loftus Roker.
Mm.
We did our due diligence. So Loftus Roker told us that he was one of the recipients of the 1973 Constitution. You see, of the 1973 Constitution. And he told us at that time how he, along with Paul L. Adley, and Ada Dion Hanna was commissioned by Lyndon Penland.
Right.
You see, the actual name of that document is called the British Order.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you look at it, no matter what occurs in our country, it could be placed at the feet of the system.
Mm.
It never contemplated. No one who held you in any condition, right, decides to release you and just have this philanthropic nature, humanitarian yeah. nature to say, I can make sure now you receive mobility.
The Europeans call it carte blanche.
You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It just don't happen.
Mm.
So what they did was they put us under a system that would create a mental stagnancy to such a degree that
right.
we wouldn't even believe that we was in even a worse condition than we were when we were in overt bondage. You see? And so what we brought now is this, and what we say now is this. Again, we have to go back to the information we have brought.
Right.
When I tell you that we have a structure in which if we were to operate on tomorrow,
mm-hmm.
the many, many conditions that you're seeing in this country would mm-hmm. literally be removed.
Mm-hmm.
You see, when you talk about the many murders that is not being addressed in this country, it must be understood, like you said, and I totally agree, right, that this is pre-planned.
Mm.
We have heard, but this is something that we all have identified with, right? The fact of the matter is this country is intended to be overrun by foreigners because of what the country represents. This is considered demographic-wise to natural resource, the richest country on earth.
Could I put this to you, fine gentlemen? Do you think it is the plan for the residents who were born on this in this what we call the Bahamas, for us to get fed up, leave and go to Canada and the United States because you know they want their playground back.
Yes.
They wasn't anticipating it was going to be so much a we.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
They didn't anticipate this.
Mm-hmm.
So could I put it to you that the intent is for many Bahamians,
mm-hmm.
all the melanated people, to get mm-hmm. so tired of being here,
mm-hmm.
and it's already right, happened. To leave this country and go back, you know, some people call it a repatriation,
mm-hmm.
right? not back to where we first came from.
Mm-hmm. Our roots.
But other people race, mm-hmm. I can use the word enslaved this time, mm-hmm. to be enslaved into another system.
Indeed.
So they could have their system back here full affair.
Mm-hmm.
Do you all believe that there is hope? Because a lot of us has already lost hope.
Indeed.
And you know who losing the most hope? The same young brothers.
Yes.
You see, like dudes like me, you don't know 50.
Yeah,
I ain't got nowhere to go.
You don't look it though. You don't look it.
I ain't got nowhere to go, big man. My, all my roots done here. You see what I'm saying?
Yes.
So when they say they going, I say, I wish you all well.
Yes.
But I ain't going nowhere.
I ain't going nowhere either.
You see what I'm saying? Do you, do, how do, and I can let you all close with this, right? How do you intend to save the younger ones? See, because they ain't interested in all this talking, you know.
Indeed.
These people hungry. They hungry. They ain't no. They ain't interested in him, but Jesus. They ain't yeah, but Salathiel. They ain't into him, but Jehovah. They ain't yeah. They ain't into none of that. They ain't into him, but who come in to vote? We need your vote. They ain't interested in all of that. They want to know how it is that we can eat.
In our system, we have what we call kitchen table issues.
Right.
That we present to the people.
Come a piece of kitchen
which
table.
Which is our problems.
Just one.
And which is our solution. Well, okay, we could look at the high fluctuating gas prices, which is already an effect and problem on the country.
Okay.
That the jitney drivers now are advocating for higher raise pay when the mother's already struggling trying to come up with the $1.25. Don't have that $1.25 when they'll tell you where you come from in a different version.
Yeah.
So again, now, why don't the elected officials take it upon themselves to say, well, okay, we just already charged dollar tax on every gallon of the fuel. Why not allow the jitney drivers to get this at the pumps? You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So they could be exempt.
Or whatever increase that they want. If they want a 50 cents increase, give them 50 cents off of the gas price.
Indeed.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay.
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 So it doesn't have to affect the citizens catch who has to rely on the bus system.
Okay.
Let's look at the foods that we eat and being imported into the country. We actually showing our dependency of our food being imported into
man,
the country,
Bobo, which is not... you ain't want to go there, man, because then now you can cost me go talk about bombs and all these. We can talk about that on the next show. No, no.
These are the kitchen table issues.
Yeah, see, because there are plenty
and
questions.
And we get a list of them with the solutions.
See,
the solutions.
See, but there are plenty questions, right?
Yeah.
The niggas need to ask.
Indeed.
And they can't allow you, Bobo, to just come here and sprinkle a little bit of black pepper and salt on me. No, no, no. Mm-hmm. I can't let you treat me like that. I can't let you do that. I want to hear the whole story. See, because then one of the things what I used to have a problem with people who try to govern the country, right? They only get the ideas when they in power. You see what I'm saying?
Can I say something brief?
No, hold on.
We ain't asking for no one to put us in, nor do we saying that we want to govern.
No, hold on. Lying out. All right. Because we can get into this on the next show.
Okay.
We can get on the real streets on the next show. So
bring it.
Let me let you finish your thoughts.
I like this.
I just want to add that this system that we want to implement. It doesn't call to go into the polls or marking no X.
Okay.
In and around.
We are, every citizen are their own representative.
Man, I ain't letting you sprinkle no more black pepper, me. You go ahead, Neil. Go ahead. You got too much black pepper. Let me see if this one can be sold.
I can keep it brief and keep it quick and to understand why we are the state we are in. Understand this, right? Before 73, that's when you had all the riots and things coming up and... So the question is, what happened? Why are we so quiet? Why are we so silent? There's something that also happened in 73. We're given a stake. We were given a stake into something, right? What were we called before 73? Was it Bahamian?
Loyal subjects.
And what were we before loyal subjects?
Enslaved subjects.
Now watch this. So 73 comes along,
yeah.
And all of a sudden now, relax. All Bahamians.
Be all equal.
Be equal.
Yeah,
however, though, when it came to that economic part, it wasn't equal.
No equality.
Right? So what we're saying here is this. In order for us to take our people to the next level, there has to be a systematic way in which we work towards transforming the minds of our people. And we have a concept and an idea that has been proven to work from other things. We're not here to reinvent the wheel. We know that there are locals here who have done great works. And has been overlooked. We know that there are people that have developed systems and plans that we're not taking advantage of. Indeed. We want them. Indeed. This is a clarion call to all our brethren and sisters who have a serious love for our country. And this is a call for them. Indeed. Come, indeed, let us build. Indeed. That's what we say.
No, I'm ready for you yet.
New system.
Yes.
This black pepper. The salt. You see, I don't tell you all, you can't come here and give people peace of the thing.
Indeed.
You can't do that.
We won't give them
See, now you all give me all juice up now to go tell myself, listen, we can run the show to 10 o'clock tonight.
Let's do it. Yeah.
But
anything to save our nation. Ain't no time on saving our nation.
Let's go. Let me say
we
this.
We are the willing sacrifices
before you
to
say
stand
the season
before
and all.
Get it done.
See, I can call you black people. You saw it in the season and oil. Right?
Praise be to the ancestors.
All praises, all praises.
See, we don't ever know where we're going to end up and what's supposed to happen.
Agreed.
We don't ever know.
Indeed.
We don't ever know.
Indeed.
And I can tell you this emphatically. Mm-hmm. You're always supposed to come here to talk to me. Now, I don't know none of my listeners. Yes. I know my brethren on the side of me.
Yes.
They ain't never leave me.
Indeed.
Right?
Yes.
See, because I can use the Christian words.
It was
divine.
Indeed.
That you all were supposed to stop by tonight.
Yes.
To talk about save the children, and then it was divine for you all to come late because we needed to get out what we needed to get out.
Yes.
So we did not have to get into all of that what we was talking about.
Yes.
It was divine for you all to come here. Mr. Black Pepper, Mr. Salt, and Mr. Season and all, to come season this pot.
Yeah,
see, because the pot been on the fire bubbling for a little while. Mm-hmm. May not done to put in the pot.
Hey.
I can tell you all, we invited people from all over the Bahamas. Mm. Now, we had some notoriety people, some big name people passed through.
Okay.
Right? And we had some people who come to talk some things. Mm-hmm. And they're still a part of our community. And we grow in our community on New Vision Media. We don't skin deep there. When we say this the community station, this is what this is. You see, we in a community.
Indeed.
Hey, bring it,
indeed.
We are not sanctioned by no rules of work and all these other things. So we could talk some things and we could put it out there and who don't want to listen, listen. Who don't want to listen, don't listen.
Precisely.
See, we ain't governed by nobody who can tell us what to say because we ain't sponsored by nobody. And when we do get sponsored from people, we say, hey, listen, this is what we all about. Go take a look at our content and if you want to be a part of that. Mm-hmm. Right? Now, Mr. Seasonal, and I can lay you. Because then when we come over here, we can have another conversation. But you go.
First and foremost, I would like to say to the brother, your brethren, right? Mm. Excuse me, sir. How old are you?
32.
All right. My nephew was killed, shot 9 times to the head in 2021, right? I come from I'm the 7th child. There's 12 children, right? And so I have a big family, right? And when I left home at the age of 22. I came out at the age of 50 out of prison. I'm 55 right now. He was about 5 years old, you know, and it hurt me. I love him. This was the only family member that I knew had my interests. So I cannot tell you how his murder made me feel. I feel rage, but I understand that the murders that is happening upon our street is intentional. You see? First and foremost, I want to talk to you and tell you, do not lose hope. You all are the ones, any general with his sword, when he sees a country that he intends to invade, always target men of your ilk first. You see? And once you all are wiped out, they figure the country is ripe for picking. Mm-hmm. Our country is under invasion. From the time I came home, I've been saying this, we are at war, and not a traditional war. You see? At every quarter, we're being attacked. But what we are doing is, I read 1990 while incarcerated. The thing about oppression is that it turned the oppressor against each other as opposed to against the one who created the oppression. So, brother, what I want to tell you is this. We need men like you. Mm. We have a small window to change things. But I am of the belief, and my brethren's with me of the belief, and a small group of people that we've begun to gather of the belief that there is hope. We need men like you to come on board. We developing a structure in which everyone is included. You see? And this is a serious structure. To have a nation of people, we need every possible person involved in this. You see? And so I'm telling you, this is our country. I ain't selling you no dreams. In my lifetime, here's what will happen. And I want you say you go hold me accountable. I want you to hold me accountable to this. Here's what will happen, brethren. This country shall be taken over. There will be no more party division in this country. We will abolish all concept of party division. We have developed a structure called family unit. And each family unit would not only profit of the natural resources and raw materials that would quite naturally become nationalized, right? But we will ensure that every family has a say-so in the precinct of the people. We're not talking it. We're not talking about bringing another style of European government here. No. We're not talking about a Republican or any of the foolishness. We have tried all their forms of governance. Our form of government, according to one of our greatest historians who wore many hats, Sheikh Ante Diop, he wrote a book called The Cultural Unity of Black Africa. And he showed that Black Africa was proven to be the same, one root, because of one primary thing, our forms of government. And that's why you see the term in our government, kingship, that carries the Mavu principles, very important, the balance of the male and the female, not one over the other. We can do this. It's already here. It's already started. You see, right now, you see everything that is being exposed in our country and occurring in our country is the fact that this system has been made and it's out the door. The transition is actually smooth. It's not a hard transition. We will have an army in this country. That civil force that calls the police force, the paramilitary force that calls the defense force, and many other persons in the society, like the young men that are actually killing out themselves, will become part and parcel of protecting our airspace, our sea space, and our land space. Our goal is to become, is to create a model that we can send this model to Haiti, where there's disruption, Jamaica, where there's disruption, anywhere where there's a black nation. And once they put in place this model, we will break the stranglehold that the Europeans and the Asians and even the Arabs has placed upon us through their religion, through their presence around us that have us following their concepts, philosophies, and ideology, and everything. We are not just talking. I want you to hold me and hold Honorable Priest Simon and hold Neil our proverbial foot to the fire. This country will not come to an election. I don't care what they say. We have information that we're going to saturate this country with. This will not come to an election. The ancestors have sent men and women back home to do a particular job, and that's what we are doing.
Stick a pin right there. You ask me, hand him the mic.
Truly.
Can I talk to him?
Yeah, go talk to
him. I say, can I talk to him, bro?
Speak to us, bro.
See, when the big brother talks about losing hope, I ain't lose hope in the country.
Okay.
I ain't lose hope in the Bahamas. I lose hope in those that govern it.
Yes.
And I lose hope in those that continuously allow them to govern it. Mm-hmm. You understand? When we talk about taking this country back, respectfully, I live to the extreme. You understand? Because the agenda of why these young men keep on kicking the bucket, clocking themselves out by force, I live to the extreme of removing those that are in power and have been in power from before I was born, still in power. The same faces I met in power from I was a child are still there. They have been there from before my inception. My extreme is removing them by force, because by force, they're making things hard. By force, they made things hard for my family. When it comes down to my tribe, I'm ready to remove you by any means necessary. The views and opinions of Lionel the Sage is Lionel the Sage, ladies and gentlemen. This does not reflect New Vision Media. I don't speak for New Vision Media. I speak for me. I speak for my people. Now, with that being said, this ain't about no hope. I got a whole lot of hope that there's going to be a set of people, young and old. And I call them set old because once you reach that 70 threshold and higher, then you reach that old point where you can now teach the soldiers. There are the teachers, there are the soldiers. Within the betweens, there are the radicals. I am one of them. So I ain't lose hope in the people. I ain't lose hope in the mission. I lost hope in the government a long time ago.
Elected officials. Those elected officials. Give thanks for that, my guy.
You see,
you put a lot of inspiration in us right now.
You see, the reason why I tell you some things is be divine. It's not, you don't know who you can meet.
Indeed.
You understand?
Indeed.
Me and him and others, we this station was founded off an argument that me and him had. In the pandemic, when the man was locking up people for selling crabs, remember that?
Yeah. Coconut.
That's how the station really started off, an argument between him and I. Never met him.
Wow.
And since then,
we've been.
You see what I'm saying?
The bond is there.
And so, you know, we just hope on Saturday that people really do show up on Saturday, because the last one, you had some other people who infiltrated it talking about it was a PLP rally.
Yeah, I heard.
You understand?
Yeah.
And boy, we've been knocking them for a couple weeks.
I heard that.
We've been throwing big rocks on them still to the day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because you can't come back from something like that. Because after he did that, it gave power to these people.
Mm-hmm.
You remember on that Monday morning, Victor Rollins? He, the guy who was opening up the gay club on Bay Street, he actually went on Shanique. He sent out a video that they opened up this gay club.
Mm-hmm.
The Monday after that rally was supposed to happen, he came out and made it big announcement how they can have this big rally, how they can have this big gay club on Bay Street. Y'all was familiar with that in the news?
No, I didn't know about that.
Well, anyhow, you know, the Christian God sent down some rain and flooded Bay Street. You know, Bay Street being flooded for a little while, right?
Yeah.
But the Christian folks say, hey, listen, God sent down all this rain and shut down the club. The fella come back and retract it and say, no, they can't have their gay club there because the place too flooded, you know. The see fellas don't can't stay on the toe and walk in all this water.
Yeah.
So the Christian people, God, you know, sort that out, right? Then when you look, a couple of weeks later, this book show up in the bookstore.
Okay.
Couple of weeks later after that, the assistant director showed up and said, listen, they can be teaching this in the school. Sunday, the Minister of Education came back and said, I don't know where y'all get this nonsense from. But I want to read something. Before we go, that's what I wanted to read for y'all, because all y'all look like well-educated man. Neil, one of your schoolmates say, boy, look at Neil. I don't know if you remember Sherelle. Sherelle say, look at Neil. Say, that's my old schoolmate. You familiar with the name?
Yeah, hey, Sherelle, what's up, girl?
All right. Let me see if I can. You don't say you're 55.
Yes, sir.
But you're over 50.
Yeah, 54.
And you but 44, 45.
On the bucket.
Okay, 45. Then. I know people business. I tell you, like, still doing business. So in school, right, we used to have English. You remember English, right?
Yes.
And in English, we had one thing called what?
Language and literature.
No, not that part. Not literature and not language. There was another component of English that we used to have. You remember that?
I think I'd have to be reminded.
It used to call comprehension.
Comprehensive. Oh, okay. Yeah.
So they used to give us an article, right?
Truly.
And say, read this article and tell me what you comprehend.
Yeah,
I'm going to read an article to you. Okay. And I can start with my learned brother right here, Honorable Black Pepper. All right?
I like that.
This is from Glenys Anna Martin in a statement.
I can stick it with you.
Okay? She said, I cannot get into the legal actions, but assertions that are made are untrue. That's a first statement, full stop. We have a curriculum, and the curriculum is focusing on literacy, numeracy, helping our young people to be articulate, to help them have the grounding in the subject matter, We have new history texts, full stop. These are things we celebrate. The distractions are erroneous and distractions are not helpful. The issue of the textbook containing the LGBTQ education to be taught in our school has been a topic of discussion of late on television, talk shows, and social media. What you get from that?
In a nutshell, that's just foolishness. Because, I mean, what is it that is false? What information is false?
Mm-hmm.
Because you come back and you end it
mm-hmm.
with the LGBT book that we're against.
Okay.
So again, it still coincides with the information Belinda Wilson gave us long time.
I can tell you something more for you about Belinda Wilson, and it might change your view on her.
Yeah.
It might change your view.
I think she's been compromised or
when I tell you what I have to tell you, you might retract that statement.
Okay.
I know these people, and I can tell you why I say that. Okay, Brother Saul.
Well, listening to that, I mean, really, there was nothing really direct. There's nothing really direct inside of the that statement. I listened to that. I watched it as well as listening to it. My issue with that is this. When she should have spoken about this, she didn't.
Mm.
She waited after the pot got a little hot.
Mm-hmm.
And even in her address, I still can't say, based on what I've heard, where she addresses anything.
Okay, good.
I've learned that whenever a politician speaks, you know, they always will tend to, you know, speak to anything using the concept of misdirection.
Mm.
So one of the things that immediately jump out when she used the term, there's the initial part of it that says that it, she can't respond to any legal proceedings.
Right.
So what that tells me is this, not that the things did not occur, meaning that they had intended to actually infiltrate the schools, that there are books and everything.
Mm-hmm.
But what she's doing is this with the misdirection. The fact that she starts off by saying that she can't speak to any legal proceedings shows me that there is some type of legal issue in relation to what she's saying does not exist, that is going on, that the general public has no immediate privy to.
You remember earlier I asked you all the question, or I was trying to provoke some emotions, and I say, you know, they had a referendum on same-sex marriage. Remember, I said that, right?
Right.
Maybe that might be the legal direction she's talking about. Mm-hmm. But what I want to draw your attention to, that's right, and this is why I say in the comprehension, she specified four or five areas, right? She says the curriculum is to focus on literacy, numeracy, helping young people to articulate, to help them have the grounding in the subject matter. And we have a new history text. Now me, you know, I only been in the grade four, right? In the comprehension class. What is the subject matter? The subject matter is discussing this LGBTQ.
And how to articulate yourself properly in it.
My Lord. You see, misdirection, misinformation. You see what I'm saying? Our people read this, oh, the honorable minister said, no, that ain't happening, but that ain't what they're saying.
Nope. Pontificate.
If what do you do? Pontificate?
Pontificate.
Yeah. You understand? If you can make a statement, and when you... If she just come and say, no, that ain't so. Or well that ain't
crafted.
Happening.
That was well crafted.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? But if you go into the English language that they so taught us, they know speak and write so well.
And comprehend.
And when you start putting commas and full stop, they mean something, Mr. Doctor of Education. Right? They mean something. A full stop is emphatic. That's it. That's the end. A comma means it continues.
Indeed.
You see what I'm saying?
That's why it's nothing clear.
The reason why it is so important that you brothers be there on Saturday, along with the general public, is to spread this information or some of this misinformation that they spreading and correct it.
Yeah,
and the only way that it's going to be corrected is you all got to be constantly in the media.
Yes.
Your days are being... underneath the dilly tree and talking to one another. Day is over, bro.
Yeah,
because y'all walk up in here with all his ancestry powers, my man.
Yes, sir. That's
y'all walk up in here with all his ancestry powers, right? And y'all done changed the whole atmosphere. So the dilly tree, them little schoolroom and thing today.
There's something I want to quickly remind you of. I'll be alluding to the topic of the gentleman who was supposedly trying to open the gay club on the street. The problem I have with that is you could go ahead and open a club and promote your club. You don't have the specify what type of club.
Exactly.
Okay. Mm. They did that same thing when they brought in the gay crews.
Mm.
Remember a couple of times they did that? Mm. They announced gay crews. They
You know how many crews is coming up?
Okay, then. With gay people on them. Mm. Why do you have to specifically specify that it's a gay cruise? So this is just part and parcel of their long-term attacks that they will get. They're seasoning us gradually.
Strategic, strategic, okay. Yes. Any of folks, listen, we can be back here on these streets next week. Same time, same place, 7 o'clock. Listen, come out on Saturday. Put up the flyer, Lano.
When does it start?
It starts at 7 p.m.
Okay.
Or you mean the rally or?
The rally.
The rally starts at 6 p.m. That's the motorcade. The rally starts at 7 p.m. All right. So we want people to come out, come and praise. Listen, we also understand that, you know, the promoters who are putting on this event, you know, if people need to make donations, you could call us here at the station 822-9563 or 454-9563. Or you could reach out to Dr. Rowell himself. You know, everybody needs some help. So if you got one little dollar or two to help fight this cause, listen, go and help support the thing. We can't do it on our own, but we need everybody trying to bring up his telephone number.
Right quickly, I appreciate the time you all set it for, because it allows even for
you all on the Sabbath.
Keepers. Okay,
right.
7-day Adventist and all those.
Yeah.
Keep the Sabbath. Yes. On another genres or denominations of spiritual systems in our country, they have that freedom that could make it out.
That's right. Bless up, right? 466-1787, that's Dr. Rowell. Call him, 466-1787. Ask him whatever assistance that you could lend or help. Please be about this movement. This is about protecting our children and protecting our country.
The morals of our nation.
All right, so we want to say continue to follow us on newvision242.com, New Vision Ads, New Vision Media. You could also find us on Facebook, New Vision ADM. That's media spelled backwards for y'all who can't spell too good. That's AIDEM. You could follow us. And then you could, if you want to reach out to these honorable men, y'all do want to drop your numbers?
Sure. Yes, my name is Salathiel Thompson. My number is 827-1412. That's 827-1412.
Neil Peterson, that's 807-7503, 807-7503.
Priest Ethelbert Harrison, or also known as Priest Diamond, 815-8147. Again, that's 815-8147.
All right, folks, there you have it. So if you could reach out to them, you could reach out to Dr. Rule. Listen, we have to stand up and protect our children. You can also go down and be New Vision Media is going to be there. We're going to be live on the parade. We can be there live. We can be there broadcasting it. So we want you all to come. If you can't make it, just tune in.
Where does the parade start?
The parade will be starting from the Sports Center, Bahama Games Sports Center, and then it's going to be ended at the Golden Gates Field.
So that's on, right Gates on the Assembly side. Park.
Okay. Right. Okay. So that's right on the side of Golden Gates Assembly Church.
Carmichael
Road. All right, on Carmichael Road. And so listen, people. New Vision Media Lano is there. You got anything for the people?
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, thank you so much for allowing us to bless your ears with our vocals this evening and these powerful men. If you have any further inquiries or anything that you have to say to us, you know how to reach us, newvision242@gmail.com, or you know the line that you could hit us on, 822-9563, that's 822-9563. Also hit us up on all of our social platforms. And don't forget that we do have a Patreon at patreon.com/newvisionmedia. That little bit helps to go a long way. And with that, I say love, peace, and soul to all.
Love, bomb.
New Vision Media, 242 to the world. New Vision Media.
Wasting time is over.
New Vision Media, 242 to the
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how.
Everybody's searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs.